Good morning. It's 6:04. I'm Willa Sandmeyer with KCLU News. The massive Woolsey fire in Ventura and Los Angeles counties reminds people it's still far from being under control. A flare-up in the rugged mountains northwest of Lake Sherwood yesterday sent a massive plume of smoke into the air. It was visible as far away as Los Angeles and Santa Barbara County. A fleet of more than a half dozen helicopters, aided by a gigantic DC-10 air tanker, corralled the flare-up in about 2 hours. No structures were damaged. The fire has burned some 97,000 acres of land, or an area the size of the city of Denver. It's now 40% contained. Full containment had originally been projected for Thursday. The target is now Saturday. Two deaths, which are still under investigation, are believed to be fire-related. Three firefighters have been injured. The official tally of structures burned stands at just over 430, but firefighters say that number will grow as a comprehensive survey of the burn area is completed. A community meeting is planned for Ventura County residents tonight, residents affected by the Woolsey brush fire. Assistance for fire victims and public health concerns. It will also look ahead at flooding potential when we get rainfall in the burn areas. County officials say they are planning additional meetings in the future to help fire victims. The town hall event tonight will take place at the Thousand Oaks Civic Arts Plaza beginning at 6:30. The deadly wildfires burning in California were discussed by both outgoing California Governor Jerry Brown and Governor-elect Gavin Newsom when they met with reporters yesterday at the state capitol. Reporter Nadine Sabai has more.
Governor Brown says the intensity of these wildfires is what he calls the new abnormal for California.
The winds are faster, the temperatures are hotter, the soil and vegetation is drier. This is unprecedented.
The long-serving governor says receiving resources from other states is much needed and appreciated. Meanwhile, current Lieutenant Governor Gavin Newsom says his transition to being the state's chief executive has been a reality check for him as the state continues to battle these year-round wildfires. In Sacramento, I'm Nadine Sabai.
A water district which serves parts of the Conejo Valley suffered major damage during the Woolsey fire, but officials say they were able to keep water supplies flowing in most spots as the blaze moved through the area. The Las Virgenes Municipal Water District suffered fire damage to its water filtration and composting facilities. Power outages affected the system, but managers were able to borrow generators from other water agencies to stay in operation. There were some areas where there were localized water outages and low water pressure due to breaks and leaks. Those were related to homes destroyed by the fire. About 500 customers south of Westlake Village have been sent notices to temporarily boil water that's being used for drinking or for food preparation. It's 6:07. You're listening to KCLU.